Hello. Last time we have seen projection of solids. Okay, we have started and different nomenclature, different kinds of solids, which are those that also you have seen. Entire elements also we have seen. Now today we will start its exercise. Okay, so very simple object, simple solid I have chosen, that is square prism. What is the narration that I will see? Okay, square prism of 35 mm side and 70 mm height is resting on one of its base edge on HP, with axis inclined to HP by 40 degrees, and its resting edge, base edge, also makes an inclination of 50 degrees with VP. Complete the projections. Okay, so in this problem, now we have to find out which kind of solid is mentioned in the narration, which is that square prism. Okay, its side, that is base edge length, that is side, is given as 35 mm, and it has height of 70 mm. Okay, so now from the narration, what we should find, which kind of solid is mentioned. After that, on which element of that solid it is going to rest on that particular principal plane. Now this solid is going to rest on one of its base edge on horizontal plane, HP. So we should start constructing this projection with the first figure as true shape of its base, that is square, that too on HP, as because in narration it is mentioned that it is going to rest on one of its bases on HP. That's why first figure, that is true shape of the base, that is square, we have drawn on HP by taking into consideration the resting element, that is edge, on our right hand. I have shown it here. Okay, now this square, this is the first figure. Now accordingly, second, this is the first figure, means without any inclination of that axis with HP, I have drawn, means in top view it will appear like this. So primary top view of this solid will be like this. While observing from top, it will look like just as a square. This is the first figure, I have drawn it here. Okay, so prism carries top face as well as base, that's why double naming I have shown here. A, B, C, D alphabets I have used for base. Okay, and 1, 2, 3, 4 top face corners. Prism is carrying top face and base and rectangular lateral surfaces. So first figure I have drawn like this. So in primary top view it will look like this. Its primary front image will be like this. It is resting on HP without any inclination of axis with HP. It is perpendicular to HP. Likewise, I have drawn it here, this figure. So this is the base, this is the top face. Top face corners I have named here as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, and A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash are the base corners. Okay, single dash I have used for front view, plane naming for top view. Now the third figure, as good as plane, we have to run the projection. Means what? First I have completed here, second is here, base I have drawn over HRL, accordingly height I have given as 70 mm. Okay, now this third figure will carry the first inclination from the narration. It is given as the solid, this particular square prism, is resting on one of its bases, that is C dash D dash. Okay, so the same C dash D dash point I have taken it here. And one final thing is that in case of cylinder and prism, okay, axis of that particular solid is always remains parallel to the lateral edge or lateral surface, or in case of cylinder, generator. That's why inclination carried by axis will be same, as good as inclination carried by lateral. So accordingly, the C dash D dash point, as it is, I have taken on this HRL conveniently at any distance, and from this C dash D dash, by protractor, first of all I have drawn this 40 degree angled line. Okay, and this 70 mm height I have just transferred here, and accordingly this third figure with this inclination I have drawn it here. It's very simple construction. Only 40 degree inclination you have to give to this C dash D dash, 3 dash, 4 dash edge, and accordingly by using this angle should be 90 degree. So it should remain during transition, it should remain its shape and size as it is, it should retain, that is a rectangular, it should not become parallelogram. So all the corners should be of 90, and same figure I have transferred here. This is the third image, okay, with the inclination of 40 degrees. Now naturally axis will carry the same, as because it is parallel to, just now we have discussed, it is parallel to the lateral surface or lateral edge. So same 40 degree I have once again written here. This red line is nothing but the axis of that particular solid. Now, how to draw the fourth figure? Just you have to observe from top. Same projections now through all the corners of the third image. Vertically, it should run in this way. I have drawn projections in this way. And from the first figure, horizontally. Now, horizontal A, vertical A. Horizontal B, vertical B. Likewise, you have to intersecting points, you have to nomenclate in this way. And you are going to get the fourth image as it is. A, B, C, D. And here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Horizontal A, vertical A. Horizontal 4, vertical 4. Likewise, intersecting points, just you have to nomenclate. There will not be any kind of mistake. Just you go on following all these steps. Okay. And now you have put one arrow here. As because you have to give the thick and dotted effect in this fourth image. As because you are observing from top. And this is one tilted one, this solid. Now in this case, the arrow is downward. Okay. And you are, what does it mean? You are here. You are observing from top. Observer is here. Now the top face of this solid is towards the observer. That's why it is totally visible to you. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. This surface, top face, is visible to you. I have shown by dark line. But what about this resting edge, that is C dash D dash? You are observing from top and it is far away from that arrow, and just it is hidden, resting edge C dash D dash, in top view. That's why that image of C dash D dash will be invisible. That edge is not visible while observing from top. The same I have shown by dotted line here in this way. Okay. Only one single resting edge, it will remain absent. It will remain invisible. That's why the same line will carry only dotted effect. The rest of the lines are drawn by thick line. So accordingly, the fourth image I have completed. Now with reference to the first inclination, we have reached this destination of fourth image. Now, second inclination is also mentioned that the resting edge also, that is C dash D dash, also makes an inclination of 50 degrees with VP. Inclination with HP, visible over VP. Inclination with VP, visible over HP. Accordingly, now this image, just you have to pick from here and you have to place here in such a way that this dotted line, which is the resting edge, it should carry that 50 degree inclination with VP. Now what we have to do? As because this C dash dash is parallel to AB, CD is parallel to AB. Now what I have done, this line blindly I have drawn it here carrying 50 degree inclination, and accordingly now this entire this figure with AB I have shifted it here, entire solid in this way. This image I have picked from here and placed with AB is carrying same inclination. So naturally, as it is parallel to the dotted line will carry also the same inclination, that is resting edge is also making an inclination of 50 degrees with HP. Accordingly, this fifth figure I have completed. All the corners I have named it here. Accordingly, what you have to do next? Same vertical projections you have to transfer vertically up from HP over VP in this way, and horizontally from all the corners of third image in this way. Okay, intersecting points. We have learned in case of projection of planes how to name horizontal projections, vertical projections of the same name you are going to get. That is A dash B dash. Here it is. Okay, so A horizontal, A vertical, you will get A dash. B horizontal, B vertical, you will get B dash here. Likewise, all the corners you have to name. And this third set is nothing but actual front view and top view images as per our requirement, as per our narration. Now, same way, here also I have put one upward arrow, and this arrow means we are all observers coming over here and we are observing from this direction. So the elements which are nearer to this arrow will be visible, and farthest points, farthest lines, farthest edges will remain dotted. It will not be appearing. That's why we have shown by dotted line. You see here, this top surface is also once again towards the observer, towards the arrow. So 1, 2, 3, 4 in front view, it is visible. That's why I have shown by thick line. And remaining, this A, D, 1, 4, these points are farthest points. So those are connected by a dotted line here. And again, this 3BC2, this surface is also towards us. So accordingly, those corners also I have drawn by thick line. Likewise, the entire projection of this solid, particular solid, that is square prism, we have finished. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is also carrying the same snake path. Okay. So in this way you have completed this front view and top view. Completion of position is nothing but two of the views, front view and top view, we should finish here. This completes the entire projection of this square prism.